Pastor Raul, and welcome to Good Friday service. Tonight, we remember the death of Jesus on the cross. Good Friday is the culmination of the Lent season we've been in, where we've been preparing ourselves with repentance, fasting, and introspection, all to culminate in tonight, in the remembering of Jesus' death on the cross. But none of us want to be that close to death. And unfortunately, all of us have been closer to death this year than we've wanted to be. Facing the death of our pre-COVID rhythms, exchanging them all for these. Seeing the death of well over 500,000 Americans to this terrible virus. And maybe all of that has brought you to the edge. And maybe considering the death of your faith in God. None of us want to be this close, yet we are intimately close with death this year. And here we are, still remembering Jesus' death on the cross. And why? Why are we remembering that death when we are wanting to escape it? What is good about Good Friday when we need to bring our woes and our worries and even our very lives encouraged to crucify them on the cross with Jesus this day? What is good about Jesus' death? Well, tonight, when we hear scripture and we sing songs, I encourage you to consider these questions. What is good about Good Friday? So now, let us hear about Jesus in Gethsemane, because before the cross, there was Gethsemane and Jesus pleading for his life.
A reading from the book of Luke. Jesus left and made his way to the Mount of Olives, as was his custom, and the disciples followed him. When he arrived, he said to them, "Pray that you won't give in to temptation." He withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed. He said, "Father, if it's your will, take this cup of suffering away from me. However, not my will, but your will must be done." Then a heavenly angel appeared to him and strengthened him. He was in anguish and prayed even more earnestly. His sweat became like drops of blood falling on the ground. When he got up from praying, he went to the disciples. He found them asleep, overcome by grief. The word of the Lord.
Savior, I come, quiet my soul, remember, redemption's here, where your blood was spilled. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as loss. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Thank you. The Word became flesh, bore my sin and death. Now you're risen, oh, everything I once held dear.
They also led two other criminals to be executed with Jesus. When they arrived at the place called the Skull, they crucified him along with the criminals, one on his right and the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." It was now about noon, and darkness covered the whole earth until about 3 o'clock, while the sun stopped shining. Then the curtain in the sanctuary tore down the middle. Crying out in a loud voice, Jesus said, "Father, into your hands I entrust my life." After he said this, he breathed for the last time. When the centurion saw what had happened, he praised God, saying, "It's really true. This man was righteous."
Hematidrosis. Yeah, that's a real word. Hematidrosis. This is a rare medical condition where one's blood will actually ooze out of the sweat pores in one's body, though they have not been cut or injured. It's very rare. Leonardo da Vinci there was a case where he observed a soldier returning from war under great stress, and he was bleeding like sweat. There's also a recent case of a young Parisian woman who had over 3 years, 30 bouts with this sweating of blood. And here in our text, the author of Luke says that Jesus, under such anxiety and stress and sorrow, was bleeding like sweat. He had so much anxiety about his pending death that he prays to his Father to be released from it, and he sweats blood. He also pleaded with his disciples to pray with him, but they were so heavy laden with sorrow that they fell asleep. So Jesus faced his fear of death alone, literally, with blood, sweat, and tears. This is a terrible thing to happen to anyone, let alone God's only Son. So why do we remember it? What's so good about Good Friday? Because I'm scared of dying. That's what my son said to me a few weeks ago. I'm scared of dying. You know, he was having trouble sleeping one night, and so I got my big body up on his bunk bed and laid next to him, and you know, we joked, we told each other jokes, and I showed him a music video, and we talked about Pokemon. I thought he was good. And we were quiet, silent in the dark for about 10 minutes. And then he rolls over and he says that he's scared of dying. I was really thankful for the dark so that he couldn't see my deer in the headlights look in my face. And I was able to kind of eke out why are you scared of dying? And he said that he learned that people of any age can die, not just people who are 100 years old. He literally said to me, little boys like me and old guys like you can die anytime. And now I'm not only like deers in the headlights, I'm slightly offended. I don't think I'm old enough to be responsible for the lives of three little kids. Old. I had to get out of my head. Get in the game. So I just decided to relate to him. I told him that I was scared of dying too. That when I think about it, I really don't know what will happen. And the unknown is pretty scary. So yeah, I too am scared of dying. And then I decided to take a risk with my son. I decided to share the good news with him. And I did it by talking about Jesus being scared of dying too. I told him how Jesus prayed to God because he was scared. Even Jesus, who we believe is God, felt fear. So it's okay to feel fear, it's okay to feel scared, but we don't have to live lives full of fear, because Jesus faced fear and death for all of us on the cross. He died for us so we could live free from the fear of death. I told him the Bible says something that gives me a lot of hope, and I believe it. I told him that if we confess to God that we're sinners and that we believe Jesus is the Son of God, and he actually did this thing where he went to the cross for our sins, that person will be saved. And that when Jesus returns one day, he will resurrect that person from the dead, and they will get to live with Jesus forever. I told him that if we believe this, we don't need to fear the unknown of death, because we will have life with Jesus. And ever since that night, when he has these thoughts and this fear of death, We pray to God. We pray to the Father, just like Jesus prayed to his Father. And he's relieved of his fears, and he goes to sleep. I think my son is starting to believe in who Jesus truly is, because he's learning that Jesus has power over death. What's so good about Good Friday? Friends, it's that Jesus went first. Despite his overwhelming anxiety and fear of death, he is the first of the new creation to go headlong into death. Lowly and humble, he allows his spirit to be overtaken by the death that was born out of our sins. He even allows his sinless body to be humiliated and consumed by death on the cross. By this, he was the first of the new creation to demonstrate that the power of the kingdom of God has more power than the kingdom of sin and death. Jesus is the new Adam, rectifying what the first Adam unleashed. Jesus tramples down death by his own death and wins a sweeping victory for God. But more simply put, and perhaps close to home for each of us, what is good about Good Friday is that the worries and the woes and the deaths we have all experienced this year can be redeemed in the death of Jesus, because Jesus has the power over death. He showed us that death is no longer an end in itself, but simply a gateway to new life. And that is ultimately why Jesus decides to do the Father's will and go to the cross. Because he knew his death would be effective to give all of us new life. Jesus wept and sweat and bled on the grass of Gethsemane, pleading for his life. And yet his desire for us to live was so strong, he accepted death. He accepted death because he was thinking about us. I believe that us too, by accepting death, dying to ourselves and putting our woes and our worries on the cross, that God will not only save us, but save others through our sacrifice. The death of the Christ may have been foretold in Scripture, but Jesus still made a choice. He chose obedience and death so that your and my deaths may become, through him, gateways to life and life eternal. May we too make this choice so that through life and the kingdom of God may come through us to others. This is why Good Friday is good. And this is why we remember Jesus' death. So as the worship band returns, I want to encourage you to do one more thing as you prepare this weekend for Easter. I want you to either get a piece of paper if you want this to be private, or I want you to speak it out. And what I want you to do is to write or say the woes and the worries and the fears that you want to put on the cross with Jesus tonight. And I want you to let them hang there all weekend, because something extraordinary, something beyond what is natural in this world, is going to happen on Sunday. And your life is going to change. Let me pray as you prepare to do this and hear this song. Heavenly Father, I thank you. I commend each one here to you because they are your children and they need you and they need to know that when they sacrifice, when they die to themselves, they need to know what's on the other side. So Father God, I pray you put your peace upon them, your reassurance, your comfort that your son went first. And if they but believe in him, anything that they put to death will result in life. I thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do in your people. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
to prepare yourself for Easter. What you can expect this weekend is that we'll have services online. You can log in and experience a beautiful Easter service. It's a service like no other because it's a year like no other. But it's an opportunity to worship with those all over the city and state, nation. It's been very interesting to see who's logged in. But we also are going to be worshiping in person. If you had not got the opportunity, you desire to come in person 10 a.m. at Shorewood High School, you can register online simply by texting Northeaster to 64600. Follow that link, register. We'd love to see you there. It's going to be a low-key time, but it'll be a wonderful time. Bring a blanket, bring a folding chair, but we will be together worshiping our God and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, both in history and in our hearts, in community and church. Jesus is alive because we worship a living God. So even this weekend, as we contemplate the death, we know. We know. So I bless you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And as you wait this weekend, just know that Sunday is coming. Bless you.
Grace. your name. And oh, the wonderful cross. Oh, the wonderful cross bids me come and die and find that I'm made true.